Evening all, and welcome to episode 21 of Kerbalism. Now, last time out, we started building a space station in orbit, which I'm going to continue. I did have a probe on there, a little tug, that didn't really work all that well. It confused the life out of me how to control it, because I didn't set it so I knew which way was up or down. It was round, and that was weird. Reed is on in that probe, so it can be used better in the future. However, I have kind of decided to not put the science station up on there. I've decided instead that I'm going to put the processing lab, what it is, on the moon, or Minimus. I want to build a base there. The idea being that we could have it mine some ore, process it into whatever we need, fuel, whatever, but also rocket parts, because we do have a mod that allows us to remotely build ships. Launching from the moon, or Minimus, is a lot easier. The moon's got a lot lower gravity, and Minimus is just right out the window and it's gone. So that's fantastic. It would make life so much simpler for exploring further out into the solar system. So yeah, let's give that a go and see how well we can do with it. And here we are with I think the biggest rocket I've tried to launch so far. I'm not sure exactly how big it was, how heavy it was, but it's got up here, you've got the greenhouse, because we still need to do that. We have a contract to harvest food in space, so sending the greenhouse and the new tug up there, which you'll see shortly. Let's see how gravity turn goes. I'm going to leave the roll as is, because as was pointed out in a previous video, putting these rockets on the side, they should be on the sides when the craft leans over, rather than top and bottom. That's the best way to describe it. Sort of, it makes sense. You'll see what I mean. It's easier if the ship rotates, so yeah. It got no crew on this. It is controlled by a little probe body. The new tug does have the ability to have crew in it, should I ever need that to happen, so yeah, right, let's see here. So we are looking for station, that one, set as target. Okay, so last time we launched with it in the middle of the sea and we got there too late, so this time we're going to launch with it I think just it comes over the desert here. Probably going to be easier to catch up with it then let it go, and then easier to let it catch up with us than catch up with it. Station power batteries are almost empty. That's a little thing up there, that's all right, that doesn't matter. No more extra power on station power, yep, that's okay. And there we are, right, and away we go. Right, so here we are, and I immediately saw after I pressed the launch button that I messed up. I did not change the height, where were we, this height to the 125, so we're way way down here. I'm gonna fire the engine some more here, see if I can't get us up to a much better height. I did also forget to put Kerbal Engineer computer on here somewhere, so yep, everything's gone wrong with this from the start. Let's see where we go, shall we? Epiwaps up to 125. Oh, well, there we go, just a bit more. Right, and that's a very close encounter there. That's almost excellent. So I would need two at my apoapsis. Myself up to go around correctly. And do. There, 15 kilometers was that? Intersection 15.4 kilometers. And 123 and 125. If we can't bring that a bit closer. We're getting 13 there and we're getting 16 there. That's pretty good to start with. I think I'll get into orbit and see what happens. I do need to deploy the solar panels here, extend them. That's the only form of power I'm getting in here. I didn't really think that bit through. And we've got one little torque reaction wheel. That's the one there. We've got one reaction wheel there. So, yeah, this is obviously very, very heavy. Very heavy indeed. I'm not sure if I'd do better to actually have the fuel flow down to the bottom or to the top. I'm not sure how balancing exactly works. I'll have to try and figure that one out, I think. Are we coming up to it? Something's flying by there. What's that? Station debris. Station power debris. So our target is there, approaching fast. And here we go. Right, fire the engines up. I don't think this is quite balanced right. Okay, there we are, in balance. I think this is slightly above the center of gravity, so it's off-putting slightly. I know the reaction wheel definitely is, because I had to move the probe down slightly to get the fairing in there, but anyway, there we are. We're in an orbit. We are going to be 13.9 kilometers away. I'm quite happy with that. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. I've got loads of monopropellant on board, so we can move around and change things, but right. So, what I need to do really is ditch this end bit. It's too heavy. So yeah, goodbye. Down to the little Terrier engine. I'm not going to fall into the trap of trying to use every bit of fuel out of that like last time. Oh, excuse me. And right, so we probably want to slow ourselves down a little bit. Let's turn around. Ah, there we go. Oh, she's still fairly heavy, and that one little reaction wheel isn't quite enough to do everything I needed to do, but it's good. Right, so let's fire up the engine and let's try and match our speed to the target. Okay, there we are, 3.6 meters a second difference. And oh, we're going off on some crazy thing there. Right. So let's try and point this towards our target here. Where are we? Right here. We want to bring our I can't remember what the word is for that now. The marker that basically says we're going in that direction. Online with the target. prograde marker. That's the word, prograde. That means going forwards, I think. Right, where does that put us? A long way away still. Right. I'm guessing we may need to slow down a little bit. Let's try this from the map perspective, shall we? We are 35 kilometers away. Yes, there we go. If we fire retrograde, we would in fact bring ourselves closer to it. Okay, 13.4, and we're not really getting anything more out of that, so let's try and fire towards Kerbin again and see if we can bring that marker over to there. Well, that helps bring it down a little bit more. Yep, there we are, 13.2 now. Excellent. Right, 5 kilometers. Okay. So, at the 5 kilometer mark, I think I want to try and stop us again. We're traveling 74 meters a second towards our target. So, let's warp over to here. And, the target actually flew past us. Right. So, we need to speed up. And once again, try and bring our target marker round. Overshot that one. Right, there we are, heading towards target again at 4 meters a second. Right, where are we now? We are miles upon miles away. I feel as if I'm doing something a little bit wrong here. We're definitely heading towards the marker though, towards the target. Let's speed up time a bit here. Yeah, there we are, at 4. I think I know what's going to go on here. We're going to pass it again on the inside. Yes, right. So, let's sort of semi-slow ourselves down again. Now there are lots of mods out there that will help with this. MechJeb obviously is the big one, it will pretty much do this all for you, but I feel I'm already using Gravity Turn for my launches, and that I'm already taking away a fair bit to it, so doing this manually, although somewhat tedious, it sort of adds to the game a bit, I suppose. It's yeah, it means I've got to do things rather than just letting, you know, a computer or a mod do it for me. It's a bit weird to explain. I'm not sure. I was a big fan of MechJeb, but I found myself using it for everything, basically. I would let it do launches once I unlocked that. I'd let it do the docking. Everything. MechJeb would do the lot. And I found it more like I was watching the game rather than actually playing it. So, yeah, I don't know, this is just me being a bit weird, probably. So, after lots of giggery-pokery and moving and whatnot, I'm finally coming in 800 metres out. I do need to slow down a little bit because I'm not sure exactly how close I'm going to get before I... before I get how close I'm going to get at my closest approach, basically. So, slow down a little bit and move in closer. About 600 metres by the looks of it. So, right. Okay. Now we need to start heading towards the target again. Right, there we go. Okay, I'm going to turn off the engine and enable the RCS, and we'll come in via that. We've got plenty of RCS, I think. How much exactly have we got? 700 units. Yep, plenty. Plenty of RCS, so... getting as close as we can, and then sort of come to a stop. Okay, so, I have locked onto the wrong thing. I have locked onto, that little tiny bit of fuel there that I left out here. Right, we are still heading towards the station. That's a good thing. Okay, let's head over that way instead, shall we? Not accelerating time like a madman. That would not be a good thing. Okay, so about 100 meters out, and we need to head down that way. Oh. And backwards, we need to stop now because I don't want to crash into it. Basically. That's not what I want to do. We need to stop. Oh, stop. There we are. Pretty much stopped. Right. So I'm going to have to back this onto here because it needs to attach to... either side of these. Any one of them. So let's set that as a target. Let's disconnect and leave another fuel tank up here. And let's control from here. There we are. Okay, so. Bring us to a stop. Okay. Point us at the target, please. There we are. Alright. No, don't rotate. Okay. And then using the RCS very gently, move in towards it. meters a second, that looks good to me. We're probably going to have to go down a little bit, so do that. very, very gently. Right, so, line up a bit better here. Marker on the marker, there we are. Coming in nice and gently. I actually want to rotate this now I think about it. I want to rotate it that way. I also need to undock this and rotate this as well, which would be easy enough done. We've got the other probe on them on there. Right, getting close. Turn off SES. Let the magnets do the job. And hopefully, there we are. No more power. No more whatnot. Water. Oh, yes. Yep. Of course, it's registering now that everything's gone a bit bananas, but that shouldn't matter. That should not matter. So, enable RCS again. We want to control from here. Blue. And, you know, turn off the RCS and just leave the ship like that, I think. A station, even. We've got some little fuel tanks out here, which I could bring back and dock on. Right now, what I want to do is rotate this around. So, let's undock here. Switch over to that. Rotate this just a little tiny bit. Control from here. Set as target. Move forward. And completely missed the target because, again, I'm not entirely sure as to how this tug thing operates. I get very confused as to what's up, down, left, right if I haven't got a visual feed of it. That's probably just me being a bit of an idiot. It's probably very easy to do with the nav ball, but obviously, I've got something wrong somewhere. Oh, turn the SES off. And pray the magnets do the job. Yes, there we are. There we are. Now the sun can get much better. The solar panels can get much better view of the sun. My brain may not be in gear. Right. So, control from here again. And we want to straighten up a bit. Yeah. Excellent. Right. Okay. Success. For now, do I grab the two fuel tanks? I'm not sure what that one is. Might be a third one. But do I grab them and redock them? Would that make sense? Do we need fuel on board here? And I decide that it is actually a good idea to go and pick up them fuel tanks. I can take the new probe out and find out whether the new tug, and find out whether it actually manoeuvres well, which it does. I'm quite impressed with it, to be honest with you. It's quite a nice little thing. There could be a Kerbal sat in it if I ever want to. Say, for instance, if Jeb or Valentina come up, they obviously get the ability to use their prograde and retrograde and other bits and pieces. So, yeah, all in all, very impressed with that design. I think I may have to use that again, possibly with wheels on it. Might be a good idea. So, after that little adventure of getting the fuel tank and realizing that I can't obviously attach more than one because, the probe's in the way. Or the tug's in the way, I should say. I've decided that the best bet is to run our greenhouse. I could have probably done with putting the solar panels on the other side of the station. That way I could turn the greenhouse and the she's getting natural lighting apparently. What if I was to rotate around? Would that go up? No, apparently not. So, okay, right. We are getting some very weird things going on with the station here, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, because we are now producing food in orbit. We've got 200 days left before we're going to get any food whatsoever. I need to rename this as well. Rename vessel to station, and it is a station. Except I'm very stop rotating. Right. There we go. Right. Very. Words fail me. Words completely fail me. I don't know what I was going to say there. Something, and I've forgotten. So, anyway. You've got a year of food, 200 days of water, a year of oxygen, and a year of nitrogen. I do believe we have a waste processor running here, which obviously is going to give us back ammonia from the waste, so that's going to keep that going. And in here we've got the habitat and everything running, so I think station for the minute is good. So then, I suppose it's on to the moon or to Minmus. Not really sure which one to go with yet. Minmus would be easier to launch from and land on, but it is a lot further away. That, however, shall have to wait until next time. Do let me know in the comments whether you think I should go for the moon or Minmus, or whether you think I'm just sort of overshooting my boundaries. I'm not sure if we have the technology to do what I want to do yet. I know I can't scan the moon or Minmus for resources, so I won't really know where to put it, but, well, hey, I've done crazier things, so who knows. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and I do hope to see you in the next one. Until then, as always, have fun.